Enduring light, oil lamp, is a physical reminder to spiritually keep oil in your lamp. Matthew 25:1-13 suggests that the lamp is your temple and the oil is the word of Yah. Place this nostalgic handmade lamp in your home, office, or workplace as a reminder that the only way to endure these times is to endure in light. And speaking of these times, this oil lantern serves as a small way to get prepared to face the inevitable. It is better to have it and not need it than to need it and not have it. Enduring light.
If this is your first time here, my whole life I have just depended on the Lord for everything. So I decided to pick up the camera on this journey because I know this was the biggest one that I was going to take. I was going to bring my family along with me, and I had faith that the Lord was going to work everything.
Everybody wants the 12-hour journey.
Where you going to? What you running from? What you going through? Where you coming from? What you going through? Where you coming from? Everybody wants to know what you going to do. Where you going to? Cause they want to come. Where I'm showing you.
That takes 9 months.
This is Realtor Beavers. Realtor Beavers, she's showing us our new home. Yes.
Hey, this one right here, I already see it.
Oh my God.
Oh Lord.
Yeah.
Why do we need to look anywhere else? We don't need to look anywhere else.
This is it.
This is crazy.
We're gonna stay the best for that.
Welcome family. This is your favorite girl, Diamond, and I'm back with another video. This video, we are starting off live, vibrant, and exciting. We're looking at new homes today. It was such a relief to know that there's other options for us. So we're just looking at these homes and all the features of them. And like my realtor would say, this is not your grandma's mobile home, honey. My realtor, Deira Gladney, is one of the best. She did not show us this home, but she is, you know, so good at getting people in their homes. I mean, just look at these mobile homes. Like, you wouldn't even think a mobile home would look like this, but it really is just a home that they created at a facility and they just ship it out to you. So that is essentially what a mobile home is. But looking at all these features, I was so excited. It took our mind off of everything and we really enjoyed, you know, just lifting our spirits up and, you know, looking at what the Lord can potentially put in our lives. So shout out to my mom for just showing us all of these houses and, you know, just being there along the way with us, because if it wasn't for her mentioning that opportunity, honey, I don't know what we would have been doing. I hope you guys enjoy this video, and until later, bye bye.
Look at this tub though.
Dang. I need that shower.
Yes.
We gotta pray. We got some praying to do. Let's pray right here.
What's up, YouTube? This is day 2 of trailer hunting, and I'm so excited. I have my daughter with me. Hey. Yes. So you guys know that right now we are homeless. Now we're just house hunting. That go hubby back there, and my daughter. Let me tell you about this little girl right here. This little girl, when she prays, the Lord hears it. Our last house, our son. I'm trying to check. Look, put your head up. Look at them. Tell them God hears your prayers. She has a pure heart. She's so kind. She takes care of her responsibilities.
She takes. She really loves. She's a lover.
Look at my baby.
Oh, I love this part. The washing machine and dryer. Back door.
What's up, YouTube? It is your girl, Diamond, aka Hebrew Beauty, and I am coming to you with an update. I told you guys that I would give you an update, and I am true to my word. All right, so I just wanted to update you guys on where we are living. I had this great idea, so for me to be at the position that I am now, it is nothing but faith. Like, I'm not even gonna make it seem crazy, because I'm crazy for the Lord. I feel and I still believe that he told me that I have to move. I cannot be in the cities. I have to take my kids out of those schools, and I believe him wholeheartedly. Like, it just makes sense to me. Why would I be renting a place for, you know, almost $2,000 a month when I could basically have a place in Alabama where I'm going to be able to be self-sufficient. There was a will, there still is a will at the place that we came to. We had gas, a stove, so, you know, if the electricity go out, y'all know about my oil lamps. I am big on being self-sufficient when it comes to, you know, being able to take care of your family. So we had, you know, the gas stove, so if the electricity go out, we'll still be able to cook. I was gonna get a solar generator. I was gonna make it really, really nice. But you know, things change, and the Lord, he know that I was so focused on getting there, nothing got in my way. So when I got there, he changed, you know, everything around. I couldn't even see what was coming. And that is faith, because I never, not once, gave up on that house. I never went there and said I couldn't do it. I said I can do it. I even started recording, you know, day in the life of living in the fixer upper. I'm gonna put that right here. Yeah, like I never lost faith, but God, he saw something better for me that I couldn't even see for myself. Like, if he would have came down there and told me that, you know, I'm gonna have you in your own place, you guys are going to be able to purchase a home down there, just go. I came down here for something totally different than my situation is now. I'm actually living with my mom now. When I did live with my mom, we had a lot of conflict. And it's because I used to talk back. I used to think I know it all. And then I had a kid in her house, so it just wasn't ideal for her to have a grown-ass teenager that thinks she could talk back in the house. But now I'm there. I see her kids, which is my brothers and sisters. And I'm like, I couldn't have been like this when I was a child. And then something popped in my head, like, ding! Diamond, you said you wanted to be a youth outreach speaker. Just, you want to help the youth, your brothers and sisters. And I see that.
Jeremiah 29:11, for I know the thoughts that I think toward you, saith the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end.
I see it coming. The Lord, he brought me down here for. He said, I'm worried about what I'm gonna eat or drink. But I'm gonna line you up with your purpose. And did he? So here I am, like he said, you can't do it your way. Taking care of, or being an inspiration to teenagers is difficult. They already made up their mind. They already looking at their idols. They figured out their role models, and they know what they want to do. They know how to dress, they know how they want to look. And they know that anybody that get in their way gonna have to move. So I have a younger sister, she's 14, and I see me and her, and she's trying so hard, and I know she's so beautiful, but I know she's gonna make the Lord proud. But that attitude, honey, Woo! So we got into it a lot. And I even had to catch myself from fighting her. Because I have to remember my purpose. You're not here to fight. You're here to heal. And I remember that if I do want to be a youth outreach specialist, I can't be out here fighting these people, kids. I cannot be out here fighting kids, period. Like, no. I have to come up with another way. It got to be another way. So as I'm living in this house with my mom and my four siblings, my husband and my three kids, 10 people, I'm just taking it all in. So I'm learning how to be an example without talking. I'm learning how to be an example using the scriptures. I'm learning how to let them see me pray. And Isaiah, they asked the Lord, if you turn the sundial back, then I'll know it's you. How they always used to ask God to prove that it's him that's speaking to them. And I did that. I did it 3 times. And he said, that is okay. But I'm going to go back to school. And each time I just want him to say, no, it's not okay. Because I need to protect them. But like you said before, they're my kids first, before they're yours. I just gotta let it go. Gotta let go of that dream. Because it's not my kids. I'm all, like my husband said, he always encourages me. And I just praise God for, to have a man like that. He said, you'll always be a teacher to them. You're a life teacher to them, but gain the skills that you need so when they get older you know how to deal with them. And this wonderful idea popped in my head, you could be a substitute teacher, girl. And it's like, girl, do you know what substitutes do? They come in the classroom and the kids disrespect them. I'm already sounding country, y'all know where I'm at. But they come in the classroom and the kids disrespect them. You gonna do that? But you gonna fight the kids? You can't fight the kids. You gonna lose your job. And I came down here to be a housewife, so now I'm out here looking for jobs. Like, stuff is different. Like, everything is, you know, things are changing. But I feel like I'm lining up with the Most High because my intentions are pure. But being a substitute teacher is on call, so I'm out being a house most of the time. Just go when they need me, and I'll be able to obtain the skills that I need, you know, so I can continue on my journey of being an encouragement, being a sister, being the tightest two women to the community. So I praise God for that. Update on where I'm going. So since we are not living in a house that I came down here for, the Lord is blessing us with another house. We're able to purchase our own home. That is something that we wanted to do for 2 years, 3 years now. And he just surprised us with it. Like, oh no, y'all gonna purchase your own home. So that's what we're in the process of doing. We are living on some land that my mom has
We're getting it cleared off on next week. On the 21st, it's February. So February the 21st, we'll be getting the land cleared off and making a spot for our new home to go. I'm gonna have a garden. I will be in my own home. I'm just gonna be the best role model I can be. So, you know, I can teach my people that they are kings, they are queens. And if you catch them young, I know that teenager is the hardest year to, but God. And that's all I'm making my bets on. So I don't want this video to be too long. I thank you guys for joining me in this journey. It's not a destination, it's a journey. Whatever you do, stay Lord willing. Because you never know what's next. I love you all. Peace. It's my birthday tomorrow.
Rewinding it all the way back to our birthday party. This is me and my husband's birthday, January 31st. We have the same birthday.
Good.
And welcome to my party.
Good.
Josiah in the building, and you know what it is. You know I'm about to get the roller.
Hey.
And Max in the building, yo. Precious in the building, and you know we cannot play.
Okay.
B play every day, you know it's a race. Amaya in the building, Amaya in the building. Dre head kids, you about to take it off in the road.
Okay.
I know Amaya can drop, you know it rap. I know Amaya can rap, she knows she
come
rap.
On, Amaya.
Amaya, drop the beat. And you know what's
drop
up,
that
Amaya, drop that beat.
Drop
and
that
you know
beat.
What's up.
Boom.
I know that you noticed that. So, I'ma rock with that and that.
Hey.
The dread hit cooler than you back. I'ma put some good in the dread hit keep you black.
Hey.
Hey, every day I walk in the morning, and I see the dread hit keep on.
Dread
every day we drop it in the morning.
Hey.
We don't be playing, we be working hard.
Hey.
We rich all day. We don't be playing, no.
Hey.
We rich all day in the
hey. Hey.
All day. We rich.
We rich.
No
fun.
We rich.
I got 29.
Oh.
I got 29.
Hey.
I got 29.
Hey.
It's your fire building. He rock in the building. Hey. Every day I walk to the mountain, he be building. Hey. Every day I stay you in the mountain, and then you be starting those bastards like a pony. Every day.
Yeah.
It is better to have it and not need it than to need it and not have it. Enduring life.